Hello guys, I got a nice mat technique for attacking the turtle. It's one of the things I love to do, is attack someone's failed throw when they turtle up and get that win. Use that small window of opportunity to make something happen. A lot of guys out there I can't throw, but I'm able to beat them on the mat because I have things I go to immediately in certain situations. This is a Gwakyu Waki Gatame, reverse arm lock, and the way I get it is they've attacked me with a forward throw, maybe a drop knee suinagi, something like that. I'm gonna break them down flat. This won't work very well if I go for them on their while they're still on their knees in turtle, because he can roll out and we don't want him to roll out. We want him to get locked up and tap and never forget not to mess with me on the mat. Okay, here we go. So I'm gonna, first thing, the way I'm gonna break them down, I'm gonna wet block his thigh right here, like karate chop his inner thigh, and even try to knock his knee out and break that base and get under this arm, and then drive off both feet and act like I'm sprinting and running forward so I can get that arm there. Okay, I want to grip his arm, but really I want to grip his hand right where his pinky meets, right here. And that's real good leverage. You can ask him, it's almost like a little joint knot right here. And that's gonna help. The little joint knot's gonna make this big joint knot that we wanna make. Now I'm gonna pull his hand out. There's some things I don't want to happen. I don't want his arm to go under his body or where he can grip it with his other hand, because that might thwart my endeavors, and that's not what we want. So I'm gonna pull it under his own armpit and twist it, and I'm gonna keep this pressure on his head where he can't pop up to roll. Sit out on the other side, pull it up, okay? One other way I can do that, say my arm is under here, maybe try to sotomakakomi, or maybe just the way things worked out, I was able to get under his arm. If I can go immediately here and then drive him down and break this arm under, that's good too. And you got that. Even sometimes I'm just here and I can just get his gi. Like sometimes I'll fake a choke, he'll go to block it, I'll just get his gi. And then I pry this thigh out and drive him over, I gotta run right through him. Keep that pressure on his head, sit around, high leg over, tap. It's a really solid move. If you drill it, he'll surprise some people and won't hit it again and again on the same people. But it's always there in your back pocket. You see the opportunity, you take it, you get an easy tap. Thank y'all.